everyone. I hope your day is going well, and if it's not, maybe this video will help with that. What is this video? Well, it's another episode of Zilog and Moto, the 110th, actually, which is mind-boggling to me. And yet, I'm not even a tenth of my way on the journey through the Master System, Genesis, Sega CD, and 32X libraries. There's just so much stuff to look at, and you never know when you're going to find something cool that you weren't aware of, or maybe something that maybe, just maybe, isn't quite as good as everyone makes it out to be. I'm looking directly at you, Zombies Ate My Neighbors. Zombies Ate My Ass is more like it. And I know that might not be a popular opinion, but I'm asking honestly, how many of you that like that game have actually beat it without cheating? Eh? Eh? Yeah, that's what I thought. Anyway, now that I've run off half my subscribers, I'm going to need some new ones. So if doing a deep dive into the 8 and 16-bit Sega library on a weekly basis sounds like a good time to you, I'd heartily recommend you subscribe, and I'll do my best to be informative and entertaining every week for the next 25 years or so. And I'll try not to upset too many of you with controversial opinions about supposedly beloved games, but I've got to be honest, I call it like I see it, and if I think a game has issues, it's going to be reflected in the review. Which brings us to this week's game, Cliffhanger, for the Sega CD. Cliffhanger was released in November of 1993 with a simultaneous release on the Genesis. As you can probably tell by the cover art, Cliffhanger is based on the Sylvester Stallone movie of the same name, which was released the previous May for summer blockbuster season, and focuses on Gabe Walker, a ranger and expert mountain climber, who finds himself having to save his friends from Eric Quaylen, played by John Lithgow, who, along with his group of mercenaries, has managed to steal $100 million via a U.S. Treasury plane. The movie itself is pretty good. I wouldn't say it's in my Stallone top 10, but it's in the teens, probably, and the scenario makes for a decent background to an action game, and due to that, I chose the Genesis version for one of the earlier reviews on the channel because I was curious how it would turn out. But this is the Sega CD version. In the Sega CD library, there's lots of games that are in the console's catalog that have ties to both the Sega slash Mega CD and the Genesis slash Mega Drive. Sometimes there's a strange situation like Flink or the Misadventures of Flink, where the Sega CD version was released in the United States, but the Mega Drive version was released only in Europe. Or maybe Bloodshot slash Battle Frenzy if you're in Germany, where both the Mega Drive and Mega CD versions were available, but the US only saw the release on the Sega Channel. But occasionally, the same game did get released for both the Genesis and the Sega CD, and we actually just saw an example of this two episodes ago with Bill Walsh College Football, where, other than the soundtrack, the actual game was unchanged. However, in the case of Cliffhanger, even though the same title was released for both consoles, and technically the Super Nintendo as well, the developers at Malibu Interactive smartly decided to kick things up a notch for the Sega CD release, adding full-motion video sequences from the movie, CD-quality audio, and including new levels into the game. Now, did those additions make the game noticeably better, to the point of making the Sega CD version worth seeking out? Or would the average gamer be fine with just the cartridge version? Well, we'll take a look at that, and go over the game in general, but first, a look at the package. And it's another Sega CD game. It's definitely odd doing two of these so close together after having not looked at a Sega CD title in about 9 months, but it's a good odd, and it's nice to look at something that's not yet in another basic clamshell. This copy is definitely not in mint condition, but thankfully the hinges at the top and the bottom of the case are intact, and there's no weird chunks broken off the case, just a few stress cracks on the front and the back. Well, there's also this bizarre scrape here that looks like someone took a Dremel with a polish tip to it. No idea how they managed that one. Back over to the front cover, and this is more or less the same cover art as the Genesis version, which shouldn't be too surprising. However, one design choice that I thought was interesting, and is actually shared on all US releases of the game, whether it's the Genesis, Sega CD, or Super Nintendo game, or the slightly different NES, Game Gear, and Game Boy release, is that the movie logo is rotated 90 degrees and displayed vertically instead of horizontally, like it was on the VHS release. I actually like this decision a lot, as it goes with the vertical nature of rock climbing, and it especially fits on the Sega CD cover shape, which has a skinnier surface area than other titles.
One other interesting thing to note about the cover is the VRC rating. The Genesis version of the game only carries a GA rating, which honestly is a bit weird considering the game is a beat-em-up and features a few weapons as well, so there's plenty of violence included, just no blood. My only guess is that due to the inclusion of the scenes from the movie, and the controversy that Night Trap kicked up in the year before, Sega thought they had to rate the Sega CD version as MA-13 instead. But again, they really both should probably MA-13. Flipping over the back, and it's a pretty traditional layout here. However, I remember the Genesis version not having the best quality screenshots, and it's clear that whoever did the Genesis screenshots also did these, because they're nice and blurry as well. Interesting to note that there are two screenshots of features that are exclusive to the Sega CD version, with an absolutely horrific-looking FMV capture, and then a shot from the snowboarding sequence, which actually looks to be from a beta version of the game. Take a look at those bytecodes at the top. I don't know who authorized that still frame from the video sequence, but they had to know that looks horrible, right? As far as the flavor text goes, they do a good job of singling out the Sega CD specific features at the top, and I actually had no idea there was a full 20 minutes of video included. That's actually a lot more than I was expecting. The rest of it's basically just rewritten from the Genesis version, which makes sense because about 80% of the game content is the same. Opening up the case, and no foam rubber insert, but the disc looks okay. As far as the manual goes, on the outside it looks pretty decent, but as soon as you open it up, you can see that there's definitely some light water damage at the bottom. It's not the end of the world, but it does just go to show that sometimes when you're buying these games, you want to take a close look at what you're getting. As far as the actual manual goes, there's not a ton here, but that makes sense as it's a relatively simple game. The controls are fully explained, including the new snowboarding mode, and there's a breakdown at the end of all 7 levels in the game, so you can see how they tried to tie the game to the movie. Okay, that's the package. Let's get to the game and see if Sony was able to improve on the Genesis version with the addition of the power of the Sega CD. When playing these games for review, most of the time before I boot the game up, they fall into one of three categories. Either I know the game well because I either used to own it growing up, or otherwise I've played it over the years, or I'm somewhat familiar with it because I've either played the arcade version or another game in the series, or lastly, I don't know anything about it because I've never played it or any other version of it, if another version exists. In the case of Cliffhanger, going into this review, I put the Sega CD version in the second of those three categories, because even though I really hadn't played the game at all, I had played the Genesis version extensively when I reviewed it for episode 10, and it was also one of the first Sega CD games I bought when starting up this collection. So I put it in long enough to watch some of the included video from the movie just to test things out. However, even though I felt like I thought I knew what to expect when putting the game in, it didn't take very long for me to figure out that my expectations were pretty shockingly a bit off. Let me try to explain, and the best way to do that is to go over the differences between the Genesis version and the Sega CD version. The first and probably most obvious difference on the surface is the inclusion of the aforementioned video clips from the movie. When starting up the game, on the title screen, a montage of silent clips are shown as the game waits for you to hit the start button. Once you do, you're given three choices: start, options, and story. If you choose story, almost 7 minutes of the beginning of the movie are shown, showcasing the original heist and plane crash, and then Quallen and his thugs tricking Gabe and Hal into coming to help them, before forcing them to try to recover the lost cases of money, which leads into the first level. The quality of the video is unsurprisingly not great, and you can definitely tell the fact that it's being displayed via the Genesis limited 64 color on-screen palette, as the video looks decidedly brown. But at least when displayed via SCART/RGB, it's at least viewable and compares decently to previous FMV games I've reviewed on Zilog and Moto, like Sewer Shark and Ground Zero Texas. Also, I really like for how the video segments, they use the original widescreen aspect ratio of the film, rather than attempting a full-screen 4x3 version, which would have been more common back then due to the fact that widescreen TVs were still a future concept. If the video had been reformatted to 4x3, along with the low color and resolution of the video, That would have totally ruined things, and at least this way, it still feels somewhat like the movie is trying to portray. Also, the video segments aren't limited to just this intro story option. As you play the game before each level, another clip will play, setting up the action for the level that you're about to play. So, theoretically, if you watch the intro and then start the game, you'll get about 11 minutes of footage before you ever throw a punch as Gabe. I like this a lot, and while the video segments produced by the Sega CD aren't much to look at in 2021, especially with the recent 4K transfer of the movie that's available on Blu-ray and streaming, by 1993 standards, being able to essentially watch the movie while you play the game based on said movie is a pretty cool concept, and a sign of things to come for digital video. These video segments replaced the comic book-styled still screens, which told the story of the movie between the levels in the same way, on the Genesis version. Those storyboards between the levels have their own charm, and I think they're well drawn, but if I have to choose between the two options, I'm definitely choosing the actual video segments, even at the relatively low display resolution. It just seems cooler. Along with adding the intro movie and replacing the level scenes with other clips, another way in which the game has been enhanced from the cartridge version is the music. All the music in the game has been replaced with audio straight from the movie's soundtrack, and it sounds fantastic. This, of course, is one of the benefits of being able to play digital audio directly from the disc, as opposed to the FM-based synthesis the Genesis is known for. The tracks play smoothly, and any cuts or restarts between tracks are minimal, and you probably won't even notice them due to paying attention to what's actually going on the screen instead. The music in the Genesis version isn't bad necessarily, and has its own charm, but this is a clear step up and a win for technology. The sound effects in the game have been replaced by higher quality versions as well, and while the cartridge-based music isn't bad for what it is, the sound effects in the Genesis version are pretty rough, and you can tell the designers were trying to keep file sizes down to fit everything on a cartridge. Having the audio upgraded in this manner for both the music and the sound effects is fantastic, and really shows what the Sega CD is capable of in the right hands. Or perhaps the wrong hands. You see, while the Sega CD version of Cliffhanger has definite improvements over the Genesis version, from both the aspect of video segments from the movie and a much improved soundtrack and sound effects, there's one other change from the Genesis version that I haven't gone over yet, although it was called out on the rear cover of the game. And that change is the addition of the snowboarding sequences. In Cliffhanger, each level isn't necessarily just one level. Instead, most of the levels are actually made up of a few different segments. For instance, the first level starts out with a combat segment, then switches to a wall climbing segment, and then finally a segment where you have to outrun an avalanche down the mountain while going around and over various obstacles. In the Genesis version, this segment is done in the combat engine as you run from left to right, and the whole segment takes about 20 seconds. So, after playing it a few times, you'll quickly learn where you need to jump and which directions to move to avoid the avalanche. While it might be a bit frustrating at first, it's nothing compared to what you have to do to not get snowed under in the Sega CD version. Instead of the relatively short segment in the Genesis version, the Sega CD version instead implements a snowboarding sequence displayed in third-person view, not unlike more modern skiing and snowboarding games like SSX or Amped. This is achieved by using the scaling technology built in the Sega CD, and it's used to pretty great effect. It actually reminds me a bit of the original arcade versions of OutRun or Space Harrier, which ran on Sega's Super Scalar series of arcade boards. And to be honest, I love the concept as they replace two relatively mundane side-scrolling sequences in the game with two technically impressive action-packed level sections. There's just one problem. The snowboarding sequences ruin the game. Let me explain. Now, before anyone thinks that I'm complaining about the snowboarding sequences because Gabe didn't snowboard in the movie, that's 100% not the case. All these movie-based games take a bit of creative license when it comes to making a game out of something that's not a game, and the only time that really ruins a game is when something is added to the game that just doesn't fit with the film. I can see a cut sequence where Gabe has to snowboard down the mountain. It makes sense. Instead, the problem with the snowboarding sequences is the sheer difficulty and length of them. Both snowboarding sections in the game, which take place on level 1 and level 4, take about 10 minutes to complete from start to finish, if you don't die. That's right, you're expected to jump over and steer around obstacles for 10 straight minutes. Malibu at least had the good sense to include checkpoints in the level, but even with those checkpoints, the level is just mind-numbingly hard. I spent a good 5 hours playing this game to record the footage for this video, and not once did I make it to the last section of the level, which I only even know about due to watching someone else who'd uploaded a recording of their playthrough. And this is the first level! That's 5 hours stuck on the first level! I was about ready to throw in the towel and just rely on what I remembered from playing the Genesis version, but I checked GameFAQs, and apparently the designers at least had a heart and included a few cheats, with 2, 99 lives, and level skip being useful for my purposes. I put in both codes, and voila, I was finally able to get past the snowboarding section and onto the second level. As stated, the rest of the game is more or less the same as the Genesis version, with the exception of the other replaced avalanche slash snowboarding section on level 4. This means that you can expect the exact same broken combat from the cartridge version, as while the game is technically a beat-em-up, if you actually try to go toe-on-toe with the enemies, you will die and die quickly. The best way to attack the majority of the foes is with a jump kick over and over. And actually, Gabe will probably end up in the air more than Wang did last week in Kung Fu Kid if you want to be successful. Streets of Rage, this is not. Along with the combat, Gabe will find himself jumping from platforms over pits and climbing on ropes hand-to-hand across chasms while avoiding falling debris, and occasionally climbing up rock walls while avoiding enemy projectiles. While all of that might seem somewhat out of place in a beat-em-up, just remember that Double Dragon is famous, or infamous, depending on your opinion, for having similar sections in the environment that have to be navigated between fights. Believe it or not, these sections that feature platforming are actually better than the combat segments, and that's part of why replacing the avalanche segments with the snowboarding sections is such a disaster. One last thing, the level graphics remain unchanged, and that's a good thing. While the graphics in Cliffhanger aren't the best that I've ever seen, and there's too much reliance on palette-swapped enemies, at least those enemies look good and are well-drawn. The backgrounds and level art are pretty nice as well, and even though there's a lot of snow, there is some variety in there. And, as I mentioned before, even though the snowboarding sections are infuriating, they look fantastic, and are some of the best examples of scaling on the console that I'm aware of. It's a far cry from the sprite swapping and Outrun that's done to achieve a similar effect. All in all, Cliffhanger for the Sega CD is ultimately a frustrating, unsatisfying game that most players will probably end up cheating their way through if they want to see the end, assuming they even put that much effort into it. It's frustrating because there are pieces of a good game here. The video segments, while a bit rough, are integrated well, and the game follows the plot of the movie at least somewhat closely, complete with the final showdown with Quaylen. And the snowboarding sequences are technically very impressive. However, a game where the majority of the people will give up before they complete the first level is a huge mistake, and I can't believe this passed playtesting as is. I almost wonder if it was rushed out the door to be released at the same time as the Genesis version, but in reality, it could have used some more work. As a result, I'm giving Cliffhanger 1 star, and yes, that's worse than the Genesis version. While there's some interesting things here, I just don't know who this game is for. If you need a Cliffhanger fix and want to play a beat-em-up, my recommendation is to kick back and watch the 4K version of the film, and then log a round or two of Double Dragon. You'll thank me later.
Okay, that was Cliffhanger for the Sega CD. You know, there's nothing worse to me than a disappointing game. I mean, yeah, technically I gave it 1 star, and I could have said it was a bomb instead, but I do have to recognize technical merit. I'll stand by saying that something like American Gladiators is worse than Cliffhanger, but in the case of American Gladiators, it never made me expect a better game, whereas with Cliffhanger, I can see where there was time and effort put in. It just doesn't ever come together. Next week on Zilog and Moto, I'm reviewing one of my favorite games of all time. Seriously, this was a game that originally released in January of 1996, and it completely changed the gaming landscape for everything that came after it. Unfortunately, that's the PC version I'm referring to. The Genesis version, on the other hand, probably shouldn't exist. I played it briefly when I first got it, and wow, it's bad. But for the channel, I'm going to dive back in and see if there's anything redeeming at all about it. And probably need a few hot showers afterwards. Please remember to subscribe if you like this video. And remember, whatever you like to play, have fun, and be excellent to each other. Later!